Hundreds of thousands of people are pouring into Washington for these inauguration festivities, and among them are dozens and dozens of celebrities.
One of them, singer Cyndi Lauper. She's going to be sitting on the inaugural platform tomorrow as the president is sworn in. She's going to be joining us to talk about that and her role here this weekend right after the short break. We're back in a moment. Everybody, there's some girls in the crowd who want to have fun. There they are. That's a big cheer because, of course, it's singer Cyndi Lauper who's joining us now. Those lyrics, Girls Just Want to Have Fun, catapulted her to international fame back in the 1980s.
And
her attendance, of course.
There's no doubt. There is no doubt that her being here tomorrow at the inauguration will be fun. But it really isn't just about the fun. You were invited here by the House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi. Explain that to
Leader
me.
Leader Pelosi. Well, I'm a huge fan of hers because she's fought for the middle class. She's fought for women. And, you know, we're still not there yet with the equal pay thing, but at least now we can sue for it, you know. And she's fought for the kids, for education. She was behind helping the don't ask, don't tell. I mean, I'm really hopeful for the next 4 years, honestly, because I think the Republicans might stop trying to derail the president and every step he tries to take, because it's almost like they want him to fail. They're just trying to make him fail. And you know what? When you make our president fail, you make our country fail. And you know what? The people elected him. Not just by a little, a lot. So that's the voice of the people. So let's get on the people wagon and make the country a great country again.
You've said the things that are most interesting to you and most important to you are being a musician and being an activist, especially when you're fighting for equality. Have you seen some great strides, certainly on the equality front, but also some big obstacles?
Well, at least our president evolved. You don't always have a president that says, oh, I evolved. Evolution is great because, you know, information. Sometimes you don't have the information, you know. So to me, that's great. Like, you know, the gun control thing. Listen, nobody wants to take all your guns away, but is there a reason why you need a 30-bullet, magazine, you know, instead of a 10? I mean, come on, who are you, Rambo? What are we doing here? It's the kids. The kids want to feel safe. They don't want to feel like they're going to school afraid of Rambo.
When did you become political?
I'm not. I'm just in the
election. Yes, you are.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Be quiet about everything? If you're singing to people and you see the discrepancy, you got to say something.
You don't seem like the quiet type. One of the issues that
you speak
most loudly about, of course, is gay rights.
Yes.
A lot's been done the last 4 years. The president's evolved, as you said, changed his position.
Yes.
What is there left to do?
Well, I'm working on the 40 to None project, and Senator Kerry has a reconnecting, I don't know what's going on with that, but he had put forth a Reconnecting the Families Act. Let me just cut to the chase. On any given year, say there's 1.6 million homeless kids. Up to 40% of them are gay or transgender, right? Now, here's the discrepancy. Only 3 to 5% of the overall national youth identify as gay or transgender. So that means those kids are either running away or getting thrown out of their homes like hotcakes just because they're gay or transgender. Yeah, that's a problem. You know what I mean? Because that's a fixable problem. So that means why don't we put them in some family therapy, talk it out before the kids are on the street. Because the kid, you know what? The street's a tough place. No matter how tough you think you are, the streets are tougher. And they start from 12. You know, you can't do that. These are our kids.
The statistics are terrible on that front. The Supreme Court's going to take up some of Defense of Marriage Act. Do you think that the nation is moving on this issue, whether you're talking about transgender kids, whether you're talking about DOMA, Defense of Marriage, whether you're talking about gay marriage? I mean, do you think the nation is slowly shifting?
You know what? I think regular people don't care if two consenting adults of the same sex want to get married. Who cares? Why can't they join the lot of us like us and be just as miserable as everybody else? Come on. You know.
So you're going to be sitting up there on that platform during the inauguration. What does that mean to you?
Oh, come on. I'm going to start crying. I've been watching it on TV ever since I was little. It was Nancy, the leader, Nancy Pelosi. She's the one that invited me. She wanted me to see it. And, I mean, I'm so blown over by it.
Do you want to hear him say? What do you want in his inaugural address? And people have been talking about it and guessing about it, certainly all today. What would you like to hear his message be?
Listen, he said a lot of things already that I'm glad he said. I would like to just see the Republicans stop trying to drag the president down. I've never seen anything like it in my life. I mean, they just want him to fail. But if they do that, they want us to fail, the whole country. And that looks bad for the whole world. We could be a great country. Work together. Come on. You got to work together. Bend a little like a willow. You know what I'm saying? Can't all be one-sided. So I think the president said a lot of great things. Now, can we back him up? I'm thrilled. I love the guy. I think he tries hard. He never gives up. You know, his wife is really bright, well-spoken. Come on. I'm blown away. I just want to see everybody get on the same bandwagon. That's like moving forward, you know, and supporting the guy. I mean, don't you think so? I mean, I'm just talking because, you know.
I think you're going to have a great weekend here. That's what I think. I think you're having a great time already. And
I can't believe it. You know, I was out last year. I was walking. I had the purple ticket, which never quite got through. It was very funny.
Oh, that was with all the people.
Well, it was very funny. Because then everybody said, cut in front of the line and tell them who you think you are. And every time I did, they'd look at me and say, I thought we were all equal. And then my manager was going, no, it's Cyndi Lauper. And they'd look at me and I'd think, yeah, but I'm here with Thelma Houston, too. And we share the hate. No, I'm kidding.
It's nice to have you with us this afternoon. Congratulations on nabbing a great seat tomorrow.
Oh, gosh.
As history is made.
It's one of those bucket lists.
That's great.
You never
get
to do that, right?
Well, so great to see you here. Thanks for being here. And, of course,
Thank
you're just
you.
One of the thousands of excited people here in this town. Mm-hmm. Many of them it's behind so us right now who are no doubt thrilled to see you up here on stage
awesome.
Right now. Everyone, a big Cyndi Lauper fan. And coming up, we're going to have more from Washington. We're talking to some folks who are out there on the mall just ahead.